David said to God, "I have put my life in your hands. You won't drop me. You will never let me down." Dear child of God, have this at the back of your mind, that God will not let you down. It doesn't matter the haters. It doesn't matter those who have been fighting you. Yes, it doesn't matter those who do not want you to succeed. Tell yourself every day, "I have put my life in the hands of God. I have put everything that concerns me in the hands of God. Yes, everything that was supposed to be a concern to me, I have handed every one of them to God, and I know that He will not disappoint me." He said, "You won't drop me. You will never let me down." Dear child of God, men have disappointed you. Yes, it is true that your friends disappointed you. Those you trusted, yes, you hoped in them, thinking that they were going to do something for you. Yes, you had faith. You had some level of confidence in them because of the promises they made, because of how good you were to them, because you came through for them at some point in time, and you thought in your own time they would also return the favor. Yes, when they needed help, you stood by them. You were everything to them. And now you feel that in your own very turn, things would also be the same. But somehow, they disappointed you. Somehow, they let you down. I want you to remind yourself every day that though the men have failed me, though the people around me, even the family members that I thought would be there for me, have all disappointed me. Yes, they've all deserted me. But I know that God will not fail me. That was the confidence of David. At the time, he was left all by himself. He knew that God was always with him. At the time, he was left all by himself to fight the lions, to fight the bears, to go with every difficulties of life coming upon him day and night. He knew that God will not leave him. God was always there with him. And so he knew that God was to be trusted. And he said to God, "I have put my life in your hands. I know you won't drop me. Yes, I know you will never let me down." Dear child of God, the Lord will make sure that you are upheld. He will make sure that He's holding you on. He would make sure that He is keeping you on until you succeed, until you win the fight, until you win in the struggles. Yes, every other person may fail you, but God will not fail you. God will not disappoint you. Yes, He will not let you down. He will not let you to fall. So turn to Him every day and say to Him, "Father, I put my life in your hands. I know you will not let me fall. I know you will not drop me." Yes, many things befell my family. Many things had befallen my life. Many things had happened to me. Yes, these things made me to cry. These things made me to lament. Yes, it got me to that point when I thought I would become rebellious. But you helped me. You came through for me. And I'm grateful to you. I know you will not let me down. I put my trust in you. I put my faith in you. Yes, when the enemies came to eat up my flesh, you stood by me. You defended me. You made sure that they did not succeed. When they planned things to destroy me, you made sure that it had no success. I've put my life in your hands, and I know that you will not disappoint me. I know you will not fail me. Yes, even the things I did not know about, the things that were planned against me, that I did not know the enemies were doing, you stood by me. You made sure that none of your plans against my life, even though I did not know about it, none of it succeeded. Dear child of God, I want you to know that every day of your life, God will pull you through. He will be there for you, and He would make sure that everything you need from Him would be given unto you. In Psalms 59 verse 10, the word of God says, "My God, on whom I can rely." This is how you'll be saying, David had that confidence. And he will go to God and say, "You are my God, and it is in you I can have my confidence." He said, "My God on whom I can rely." Dear child of God, you would also be able to rely on God, seeing all the things he would accomplish in your life. He says, "God will go before me and will let me gloat over those who slander me." Yes, they wanted to gloat over you. They wanted to laugh at you, but God did not let it happen. God made sure that you were the one that was gloating over them. God made sure that you were the one that was rejoicing over them. Yes, they thought that they had finished you. They thought that they had ended everything about your life until they saw you rising again, until they saw you springing forth. Dear child of God, no more would they be able to exact upon you all of their evil plans. And that is because God will not let you to be pulled down. God will not let you in any way to be destroyed. The word of God in Psalms 31 verse 9 says, "Be kind to me, O God. I'm in deep trouble again. Be kind to me." Yes, you can go to God. You see the troubles around your life. You see the things you are faced with. Just go to God and say, "Be kind to me. I've been in deep trouble, but I'm crying out to you because I know that you will help me." Yes, David said to God, "I've cried my eyes out. I feel hollow inside." At some point in time, he felt dejected, but he knew God was with him and God came through for him. There was a point in time in the life of Elijah. Elijah felt all by himself. He felt all alone and he wanted to take his own life. He said that he wanted to end it all. He was tired of living. He was in trouble. He was running night and day because his life was in danger. But God showed up. God strengthened him and everything turned around. God sustained him in the journey, that there were no reason for him to faint anymore. There were no reason for him to become weary anymore. Dear child of God, you will not faint. You will not become weary. You will not become tired. Rather, you will be strong. You will be courageous. You will not be intimidated in the mighty name of Jesus, because you will see God riding with you with a giant stride. You will see God walking ahead of you in the mighty name of Jesus. And he will let you know, "My child." He will say to you, "My son, my daughter, I will not let you down. I will not leave you all by yourself, because you are not forsaken." Yes, there is this admonition in Deuteronomy 31 verse 6. It says, "Be strong, take courage, don't be intimidated, my God." He said to you, "Be strong, take courage, be very courageous, and do not be intimidated." He says, "Don't give them a second thought, because God, your God, is striding ahead of you. He's right there with you. He won't let you down. He won't leave you." Remind yourself this truth every day, saying to yourself, "God will not leave me. God will not let me down. He will not allow the enemies to rejoice over me. So I will put my faith, I will put my trust, and I will put my hope in God." In Psalms 25 verse 2, it says, "I trust in you. Do not let me be put to shame, nor let my enemies triumph over me." Dear child of God, your enemies will not triumph over you. God will not allow you to be put to shame. He will be with you. He will be there to help you. He will be kind to you. He will be there to sustain you in the mighty name of Jesus. He will take care of you. Yes. And every arrogant one, the people who wanted to see that you are destroyed, the people who were frustrating your life, they would begin to receive their recompense, their reward for the evils that they have done against you. Dear child of God, the Lord is saying he will not leave you. He will give you rooms to breathe. He will cause you to be alive. He will cause you to be strong, and he will cause you to stand your ground in the mighty name of Jesus. They wanted you to fall, They wanted you to be on the ground, but soon they will see you rising above each and every one of them. In the mighty name of Jesus, dear child of God, remind yourself this every day that God is with you. Tell yourself this every day that God is right there with you to sustain you, to keep you on until you succeed, until you make it, and until you have your testimonies in the mighty name of Jesus. Know this, dear child of God, that God sees your pains. He sees the tormentors, all the things that they are doing against you. And He would make sure that He turns the story around, that every of the captivity will be turned around and your joy will come. You would have a reason to rejoice, knowing that God settled you and God turned everything around for you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, amen. God will not let you down. God will not allow the enemies to rejoice over you. In Jesus' mighty name, go ahead in victories, because there are great things for you to still achieve. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. It is well with you, beloved. God bless you, and shalom.